Yeah, I think you can, just like the totem Pokemon in Sun and Moon. It would probably have to be a post-game thing.
Probably.
We did it, Brian.
Way to go, little buddy. I'm like 2 inches shorter than you.
Did you get a good look at its face, though? I didn't expect the Titan to be such a little cutie.
Terrifying derpy one.
Little?
It's a derp.
Also, yeah, I've looked around towns, too, and you can't actually change shirts.
Mm-hmm. You can't change the uniform, unfortunately.
That's a bit of a bummer.
Especially with how many options you could get at the Galar region.
Yeah.
They upgraded the customization of the character, but they downgraded on the outfits. Double-edged sword.
Yeah. Double-edged sword and shield.
Oh my god, shut the fuck. Just get your stupid weed.
Why does it have the weed?
I knew it! Quick, use the same animation.
Mm-hmm. This is one of Europe's, make no mistake.
I will.
Oh, it's salty flavored.
Ew, salty weed?
What was the one we had before? Was sweet. It bitter?
It was sweet.
Oh, sweet. Okay. All right, now go time to make that sandwich.
What does the book have to say?
Well, apparently, salty Herba Mystica helps with aching hands and feet.
Ah, this is the derpy music.
Ah, yeah. The science music.
I call it the Boo Boo the Fool.
Right? Good for neuropathy and numbness. When you've got muscle weakness, it supposedly builds up strength again. If I could just slip this into a tasty sandwich and get him to eat some.
That's it! A new recipe! I know I did that the last time, but I'm gonna do that each time, I'm telling you that.
And Bob's your uncle.
My
special whimsical herb-filled super sandwich. And it comes with a side of a Titan badge.
Why are you giving me the badge? Oh no, the salt meme! Why does it look burnt?
Oh, is it? Oh my god, it is too.
Why is it burnt? What did you do to my bread? I know I asked for pumpernickel, but that's ridiculous.
Scarlet. I'm just waiting for like that a Pokemon Mitch. I'm just waiting for a Pokemon to pop in out of frame. Oh. God, that video was so hilarious.
Oh, come on. You again? Why are you so pissy? He wants the sandwich.
Sniff,
sniff. Sniff, sniff. Oh, hey, buddy. Of course we're gonna give him all our sandwiches.
Oh. Is it trying to say thanks or something?
Yes, it's being sweet.
Well, good thing I made extra.
You learned.
Yep. You're helping me out a whole bunch with the hard stuff, so it's only fair that you get more. I definitely absolutely did not make extra so that Koridon could have a sandwich, okay?
Not like I'd like you, Baka. Sandwich. Onion, onion, onion.
Oof.
Oh, Jesus.
Heartburn.
You're able to jump higher now.
Yeah.
How do you learn that from Worm?
How do you learn that from being salty?
I don't know.
Meow.
I think I can appreciate... I know somebody said this before. I really appreciate that a legendary Pokemon is just not being a just the trophy poster. It's literally you're bonding with the legendary at the very start. Gives you a reason to like it. Uh-oh.
Don't you dare touch that!
Don't touch it!
That ain't for you!
Don't ever push the red one! Sheesh, buddy.
Oh, he got scared. Oh, sorry. I shouldn't have shouted like that. I guess I should at least tell you the full story.
We're two titans in. Lay it on me.
Come on out, bud. Ooh. What the heck is that?
It's a puppy!
Oh my god!
My boss stiff.
My boss stiff.
My boss is stiff?
No.
Mawa.
It's either my boss stiff or Mabo stiff.
Well, I'm going my boss is stiff.
I'm going Mabo stiff.
Okay. Ah, worm.
It looks so adorable.
Well, he did refer to a Pokemon that he was always feeding it to. So maybe it's trying to make this Pokemon stronger in a sense.
Maybe it's not hungry or like it doesn't like sandwiches.
I think it's an old Pokemon that's lived too long.
Here you go, bud. Eat up. This sandwich should help you feel better.
Maybe it's a very sick puppo. Slowly.
Maybe now. It's either sick or old.
Yes.
Like Stoutland.
Just too nice and slow. Burp, 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 burp,
burp, burp, burp. It's adorable. My buddy here was hurt really bad a while ago. Real bad, in fact. Would the Pokemon Center not help?
Beyond it. Like, it's recovered.
He never really recovered.
That'd be a psychological thing. Oh, there it is.
I mean... Yeah, potions and things don't... Oh, yeah, I'm gonna say Pokemon Center.
Because that was the question you just asked.
They said this wasn't any regular old injury or illness. Okay, it's...
Yeah, it's something they can't cure.
Yeah. Mabelstiff here is the only thing in the world I care about. The only thing.
Damn.
So I promise that I make him better, whatever it takes.
Even giving him the weed. A good coach, my good lad.
I searched online, I read books, I looked all over and tried every cure and remedy I could find. But nothing really worked. I'd almost given up hope. That's when I found out about the Herba Mystica.
The HMs.
I found it in my mom's lab.
Oh.
Area Zero was home to wondrous herbs that instantly impart a vigor when eaten. We dubbed them Herba Mystica and attempted to grow some in areas around Paldea. However, before we could harvest, the herbs were eaten by Pokemon, which in turn grew large and strong. We call these Titan Pokemon.
You telling me this is just Attack on Titan?
I was gonna say, this is literally like the Dynamax mushrooms. It's this book full of crazy stories and legends and things, stuff nobody usually believe. But I believe it. I think what it says is true. And according to this book, eating all five Herba Mystica can cure anything that ails you. Case in point, Mabostiff's paws were cold as ice before he ate that last herb. But they've warmed up a little now. I'm sure they have.
Oh. Boof. Oh, you done eating, bud?
Oh.
I want to
There's
pick
life
his...
back in its eyes. He was blind.
Oh, can you see your eyes? Are your eyes open? Yes, I did it.
Check your blindness. We need this weed
it's now. It's been so long since he was able to open his eyes. I was so worried.
Aww.
Oh, man. I'm so glad.
Damn, making me care about this person? Who are you, game? Wine. Wine, wine, wine.
Aw, look at him. Those fiery orange little eyes. Hard to even tell if they're open or not, but I know the difference. The power of these herbs is amazing. I knew the book wasn't lying. I'm gonna bring Mabo Stiff's back to full health, I swear it. Oh, yeah. So that's my story. 3 herbs to go. Let's find them together.
Oh boy. And sandwich for me?
We're gonna give sandwiches to 2 good boys. That's actually so sweet.
Damn.
Aww.
You good?
Mm-hmm. That's funny, because I was just talking about a missing dog around our hometown from my girlfriend just before this.
Oh.
Hello, Brian. This is Sada.
I think Sada.
Yeah, Sada. I detect the Koridon has regained more of its original power. While you're riding upon it, it seems it can now jump higher if you press and hold the B button. I can jump higher than before.
Jump! I'll train.
I am relying on you to continue taking good care of Koridon. Right, awesome.
Ooh.
Yeah. Okay, not bad. Yep.
Nice.
I think the only thing I want to look for is the ability to swim.
I'm sure one of the Mythicas will have that.
Mm-hmm. And I can have Pomo to learn Spark. God, I really do actually love that design. It's like... it's just Pyramid Head, actually. It's a mix of Steve. Oh, wow. Oh, they just started to spawn out now. I can actually get these Pokemon now. Orthworms. Okay, that's cool. So I can catch one. But I actually make sure I won't use a Salt Cure. I thought it'd be a little bit of a fighting type with those little blue arms of his. But it really is just a worm. It's an Alaskan bull worm. Oh boy. Actually, now that I think about it, it's smaller than I imagined. Like, I originally thought it was going to be like Steelix or Onyx's size, but it's really just a small worm. In fact, probably the same size as Sandaconda. Maybe I gotta hit it one more time. Yeah. You know, I guess while I'm here too, I never really brought up the story since like, since probably like Xenoblade, that, it was about the big wedding that happened with my older sister. At least that's what I was supposed to talk about, yeah. Because I had it written down because I was like, sister's wedding up at Northern Ontario. And we had like, when did I pick up a full restore? It was actually a great weekend, though. I think we only stayed for weekends. I guess my mom didn't actually know I... like, she thought I was supposed to work on the Monday, but I actually had a day off there. In fact, I think it was the day of Thanksgiving. Yeah, it was the weekend of the Thanksgiving weekends in Canada. So we decided to have our the renting at that time. God, an earthworm. When attacked, this Pokemon will wield the tendrils on its body like fists and pelt the opponent with a storm of punches. It's 8'2". Oh my god, it's almost 700 pounds. It still has a goofy ass face.
It's the Alaskan bollworm. But anyways, it was on the weekend of Thanksgiving, and I did actually have the Monday off on that time. And I guess I forgot to tell my mom about it, which I should have. Otherwise, we wouldn't have left right after the day, or the day after the ceremony and the party. But besides that, we had a wonderful time. I'm gonna catch this guy again. This is Varum. So like all of, I do believe it was Friday or Saturday that we set everything up. It had like us family and then it had a side of,
Varum.
Yep. Little Varum. So I think it was Saturday or Friday that we set up the tents and the picnic tables. I think it took like all of most of the day. And then Sunday, I think we had the ceremony.
Are you talking about the
dinner? Yeah. The dinner was like, was it just one big pig roast or did they have like two?
It was literally one giant pig roast that they had.
Oh,
they
yeah.
broke it down. And honestly, guys, best pig I've ever had. That was like melt in your mouth kind of pig. And it had amazing barbecue sauce. And later on in the evening, they had pulled pork poutine.
Yeah, that was also good, too.
I find that having food at a wedding makes or breaks it. And that was definitely, like, the highlight of the wedding. Despite, like, the coldness and, like, the wet grounds, that was probably my favorite part. And, you know, like, our sister getting married and such, but you know what I mean. I only came for the free food.
When do we get the free food?
Don't tell her.
Yeah, I had a good time too. Like, I never played croquet before, but I immediately learned how to with all the groomsmen. The after party, though, I don't think...
You don't need to talk about it, but let me tell you. Stuff happened.
Let's just say it involved, like, at least six drinks. And then...
Those drinks were pretty hefty.
Yep, they were, and I got escorted back from our stepdad. And
that's it. That's all you gotta say.
Yep, that's it.
No more details. Nope. You weren't supposed to see that.
Yeah, I jumped too high. Okay, so... There's this whole desert area. But there is, like, three Pokemon centers in this one. I guess I should be going this way.
I was gonna say, you should be starting to go, you know.
Yeah. And I've also noticed, too, on the map, Go back. I missed another Pokemon center down here in the South Province. Mm. Well, I had to go back. I had to go there at some points. I'll have to anyways, because it looks like there's an island down here that I would... probably be able to get to. Okay, where do I go from here? Up there. Like my Overwatch 2 experience, which... Not bad, actually. The only complaints that people have nowadays is that Sojourn is still overpowered. And you can actually see in, like, top 500, like... Almost every single player on there at least has Sojourn played.
And I guess I should mention, since last time we kind of did Overwatch together, I kind of had a falling out with Overwatch. Not in a way of like, oh, I'm gone from it forever. It's more like I'm just kind of disassociated from playing the game because of all the stuff that's going on. Like, don't get me wrong, the game is near and dear to my heart. But the amount of things that have happened kind of just drifted me away from playing Overwatch 2. So if Brian ever does come up to do the PvE modes, I'm probably not going to join him. But if in some weird twist of way I end up doing so, is gonna be like a very slim chance. Like, don't get me wrong, I'll still co-commentate, but I'm right here, man!
Fuck Steve, I'm gonna fight this guy on my own.
No, Brian, don't do it! I'm gonna just throw gotta hands. Calm down, okay? Take some deep breaths with Steve. Come to my rock pudding. Oh, you hit my ass.
Yeah.
Defeat the Kabagool.
Oh, we got a woogity woo. We got a woogity woo.
Woogity swoogity. Boop.
See, as you were saying.
Yeah, it's just, if you do go into the story mode, I'll be more than happy to just, like, be an observer. But at the moment, I'm just like, I'm just kind of in a watch.
Are you a fan of sad songs or not so much? My personal opinion is they're okay.
Damn, are you a critic? Lydia!
Oh my goodness.
It's a cowgirl. I thought it was a guy, if I'm being honest.
Whoop.
Damn.
That's all he had.
And that's all I got. He had an opinion and he walked away.
Yep. It's a sad, sad loss in a sad, sad world. Yeah, I know, I get that too. Like, sometimes nowadays it gets a little bit frustrating. Especially with, like, the current meta work going on right now. Like, it used to be D.Va Zarya, and now that they nerfed them, it's now being a meta of Hog and Winston.
Like, oh, you're having fun with these characters? Let's destroy them.
What? Also, like, Genji. They nerfed his shurikens, except for Nanoblade. Or a Dragonblade.
Well, he will spaghetti as much as he wants.
You will spaghetti a little less often.
Spaghetti as a treat.
And then Sombra, they nerfed her to the ground. Which is so stupid. Like, Sombra finally had a chance of being meta or like top 500 character. But they nerfed her because everybody still hates her.
I don't usually follow, like, the nerfs and buffs only because mm-hmm. It follows towards, like, the higher team players instead of, you know, people who are just having fun.
Yeah. I try so hard to make Junkrat not a throw pick.
As long as you're just having fun, that's all that matters in a game.
Yeah.
He is what other things.
So, I think if I do this, I'll live. Yep, okay. I should actually go and make a picnic too, because I think I said before that that's actually how you get eggs in this game.
Yeah, I heard the breeding system in this game is not that great. Only for the fact that, like...
Like, you can't move around getting more eggs while you're hatching more eggs.
Yeah, it's like the breeding system just kind of got fubar. I think they've realized so many people are exploiting it, but they're like, nah.
Mm-hmm. I hear, like, people are also exploiting cloning shiny Pokemon.
Mm-hmm.